Hello everyone, welcome to another Adobe Illustrator tutorial. My name is André Kröker from Dagubi. Today I'm going to show you how to draw a cartoon face. This is my sixth tutorial on this topic. You can find the links to these tutorials down in the description of this video. There are many ways and techniques to draw in Illustrator. Today I'm going to show you how to draw with the pencil and paintbrush tool, and I teach you how to work with Live Paint. So in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to draw this cartoon face with the paintbrush tool and the pencil tool. First thing what we need is a simple brush, so please choose the ellipse tool and create a small oval. Change the color. None color for stroke and black color for fill. So zoom in. So that's fine. We'll make it a little bit smaller. And now go to the brushes panel and create a new brush. Click on this button, or you can go to the brushes panel options and click new brush. Or you can drag this with the selection tool, drag this in the brushes panel and choose art brush, click OK and change the colorization method to tints. So when you use this brush with the paintbrush tool, so you can see this. So you can make a double click on the paintbrush tool, and these are my options for the paintbrush tool. Okay. Okay, I start with the paintbrush tool and this new brush. So change the color black for stroke and none for fill. And draw your first line. So I change the stroke width. And now continue with the ear. So it's important to overlap these lines. So choose the direct selection tool and move this so you can use the smooth tool, select this line and use the smooth tool. So next, choose the ellipse tool and create a circle. Fill this circle with black color and none color for stroke. And create a second circle small circle. So this time choose white color for the fill. Now with the selection tool, select these shapes and now hold down the Alt key and move this to the left and hold down the Shift key. Now go to the Transform panel and click on Flip Horizontal. Now select these two circles and flip this back, flip horizontal. So next choose the paintbrush tool and change the color, black color for stroke and none for fill, and continue with the brush. So next I'm going to draw with the pencil tool. So next, if the nose are these lines are selected, go and click on your brush. And now I'm going to draw the eyebrows. So select both eyebrows and now change the color, none for stroke and black color for fill. So if you like, you can zoom in and change this anchor point. So choose the direct selection tool. So choose again the pencil tool and I continue with the hair. and change this stroke by clicking on your brush. Change the stroke width and now choose this tool, the width tool. Now go and click on this anchor point. And drag your mouse. So that's fine. And continue with the pencil tool. So next, change the stroke. Click on your brush. Change the stroke width. And now choose the width tool. And change this. So that's fine. So next thing what you need to do is convert this and use the live paint. So select the whole group and now go to objects and first click on expand appearance. And next go to object, live paint and click on make. And go again to objects, live paint, and click on expand. So next thing what you need to do is delete all these overlapped lines. So next I'm going to fill these shapes with color. So you can do this with the swatch library menu. So for example, for the skin tones, you can use these colors, or you can create your own color set. So I use these colors. And now I start with live paint bucket. And when you hold down the Alt key, you can pick these colors. So I start with this color. And now select the whole group. And now click on this. And now I'm going to fill the hair. So hold down the Alt key and click on this color. So, and now go to gradient, and I use this gradient. And last, change the fill color to white and fill the eyes. Okay, next I'm going to change the outline color. So I start with this dark brown. So click and drag your mouse. And now I choose red color. So that's fine. Now select the whole group, and now you have to expand this. So go to Object, Live Paint, and click on Expand. And next go to Pathfinder and click on Merge. Okay, in the next few minutes I'm going to add some shadows and highlights. So I start with the hair. So choose a group selection tool and select this shape. Now copy this and go again to edit and click on paste in place. So this is your hair. Now choose a pencil tool and zoom in. And now select both shapes. Now go to Pathfinder and click on Intersect. So next choose the gradient tool and change the color. So select the first air shape. So you can make this new shape a little bit darker. So click on this button, Recolor Artwork. Click on Edit. And now link Harmony Colors. And make this a little bit darker. Like this. So next, I'm going to select the eyes. Now open this group and select these two layers and now go to the layers panel options and click on collect a new layer. So now duplicate this layer. Now go into this layer and now choose the pencil tool. And create a new shape. Now select this shape and this new shape. Now go to Pathfinder and click again on Intersect and change this color to gray. That's fine, and make the same with this eye. Now select both shapes. Now choose the eyedropper tool and click on this gray color. So next, choose the magic wand tool and set the fill color tolerance to 0 and click on the skin. Now group this, go to the panel options and click on collect a new layer. So now make a copy and now start with the shadows. So open this, now choose the pencil tool and create a shape for the shadows. So So fill this shape with this color. Choose the eyedropper tool and click on this, or you can choose your own color. So now select these two shapes and now go again to Pathfinder and click on intersect. So next, sorry. Okay, next, duplicate this basic skin group. And now I'm continue the highlights. So choose a pencil tool. So fill this with this color. Oh, sorry, you have to do this in this layer. Now select these two shapes and go to Pathfinder and click on intersect. And now create new shapes. So if you wish, you can move the eyes a little bit. So choose lasso tool and now select first this eye. And now move this to the left and make the same with this eye. Or you can modify the shadow, for example, choose the direct selection tool. Now select this shape. So first choose the add anchor point tool and create or add new anchor points. Oh, sorry. Next, choose the direct selection tool. Oh, sorry. So next I'm going to modify the gradient and the skin. So choose the group selection tool. And now I start with this shape. Select this and now choose the gradient tool. So hold down Control key and click on this ear. And last, I'm going to add a background. So create a new layer. And now choose the pencil tool. So fill this with blue gradient, for example this, change the type to radial, so next choose the paintbrush tool and choose your brush and create some lines, make the color a little bit darker. It's fine. And now make a copy of this shape. And now create a new shape. Oh, sorry, make two copies. And make this copy a little bit darker. Click on this button, Recolor Artwork. Click Edit and now link Harmony Colors and make this a little bit darker. Okay. And now select the second copy and move this. And next select these two shapes, go to Pathfinder and click on this button, minus front. Thanks for watching. If you liked this tutorial, please press thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my tutorials, please subscribe my channel. Hope to see you soon.